The assist in basketball is the player who passes the ball to the final teammate who then scores. In tracking, we also have the assist. The sources that helped the users to convert, but didn't lead to the direct conversion, are the assisted conversion sources. To find those for your website, you can look into the assisted conversion report in Google Analytics. Today, our Google Analytics expert Pavel will lead you through the surprising insights you can get from this report so you can optimize your channels depending on what role they played in your user's conversion path. Now, we got lots to cover, so Pavel, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. Hello, everyone. This is Pavel, and today's topic is assisted conversions. Let's explain the concept of assisted conversions first. So I'm going to the report of conversions, multi-channel funnels, and then conversion paths. I decided to pre-filter a bit longer conversion path, which in this case is 6 and more. I will explain you shortly what it means. And first of all, also do the quick check of pre-selected conversion you selected. In this case, I'm interested in transaction. So I will scroll down a bit, and what this report is showing me is the flow or the sequence of channels through which user visited your website until he or she converted. I will switch now the primary dimension from multi-channel funnel to source medium path to have a more granular view and what it tells me. I will firstly show a bit more rows to find some interesting line, which can be, for example, let's say this one, line number 26. It tells me that there was one user who visited the website in this particular order, which means following these six channels, and then he or she converted. In standard attribution model in GA, which is applied to all of the reports we are familiar with, mostly speaking about traffic sources where we evaluate them, it's the report of acquisition, then all traffic and source medium, the last non-direct click attribution model is applied, which means that it gives the credit for the conversion only to the last channel of conversion path. And all previous of them would be ignored. So speaking of this conversion path, line number 29, last non-direct click attribution model would give credit to this one, gdeals.googleplex.com, and all previous of them would be ignored. And as you know, it's not fair, and there are two ways how to approach it. The first of them is either attribution, which is something we explained in the previous video, or the second one, which is about assisted conversions. This concept is quite old in GA, and let's explain it. It basically works in a way that it counts the assisted conversion to every channel which was not the last one, which in this case would be all these five of them. Of course, if a channel is twice in that conversion path, only once would be given credit for assisted conversion. So the one channel gives the credit for the last click conversion, and all the previous one gives the credit for assisted one. So this is the general concept. Every channel that was in conversion path gives some sort of the credit. This is important to know. And now let's go to the report, which is dedicated to assisted conversions, which is this one. And here we are. I will minimize the left bar. And again, first thing to check is to pre-filter only the conversion we're interested in, which is transaction in this case. And if I scroll down a bit, I will again switch to source medium to have it more granular. And here we are. This is maybe the report you're not that familiar with, so let's explain what we have there. Here is the volume of assisted conversions for every channel, which means, I will just repeat myself, every time a channel was not the last one in conversion path, it gets the credit. And here is the volume of the last click or direct conversions for every channel. And it's not important right now to worry that much about the absolute volume of assisted conversions or last click conversions. What is the most important number here is the one on the very right. which is the ratio of assisted conversions compared to, or sorry, divided by last click or direct conversions, which in this case is very simple thing. We are dividing this 4.7 thousand divided by 7.8 thousand, which gives us dimensionless number 0.6. And the same calculation is applied for every line here. How to read that report? This is the important part. I would divide this number into three groups. The first one is if the number is significantly less than one, which is something like this, 0.5, 0.6, it tells me that particular channel is mostly towards the end of the conversion path, right? We can see it also here. If the number is pretty much 1, which means 0.9, 1.1, which is, for example, this one, line number 4, the channel is both assisting and the last one. And then the last group of how to divide this number is significantly more than 1, which is 3, 4, 5, 6, even 8 here. And it tells me that particular channel is mostly the assisting one, mostly in the beginning of the conversion path, which is, for example, this one, line number 9, moma.corp.google.com, which is 19 assisted conversions and only 3 last click ones. So what this number tells me, what is pretty much natural position of channel in the conversion path. How to use this information? First of all, it's very useful specifically for the channel you own. And by this, I mean the channel where you can easily change your communication. Try to give you the example. Let's assume you're running very extensive emailing campaign, and most of the communication or the message you're trying to share there is mostly towards the end of the conversion path, which means, for example, you're trying to persuade user to buy something or to give you the lead. And if you would find out that this channel is naturally mostly towards the beginning of the conversion path, which can be, for example, line number 9, you might reconsider to change the message you communicate there. If you see that it's mostly in the beginning, you might consider, okay, I might change my communication line there or the copy more in a way that, okay, I want to get the user for the first time to my site, or tell him why am I so good, what do I offer, and so on and so on, instead of having that so-called hard-selling message there. And vice versa. If you would, for example, find out that particular channel is mostly towards the end of the conversion path, you might also reconsider the same thing. First, check what's your message there you're communicating in the channel you own, and try to focus whether it's the right message you're communicating there. So this is one of the usages assisted conversions can give you. And then there's a second one. If you would, for example, find out that you have a significant volume of assisted conversions for a particular channel you own, and you spend a lot of money there, and your expectation, of course, is to open the conversion path, not close it, also try to evaluate that channel or the group of the channels by the volume of assisted conversions instead of last click conversions. The typical example are display brand campaigns, where most of the communication is, okay guys, here we are, this is what we do, and we want to bring you for the first or the second time to our website. So this is also the goal of the channel, just to bring the user for the first or the second time to your website instead of closing the conversion path. So another great usage of assisted conversions to tell you if a channel you consider to be mostly assisting one, this is the great report to evaluate that. So that was it, guys, about a very simple explanation of what report of assisted conversions are and the concept itself. So hope you enjoy that and see you next time.
All right, thanks, Pavel, for this great explanation. If you enjoyed this, then hit that thumbs up button. And if you're interested in learning more about Google Analytics, check out this playlist over here, where you can learn more about how you can use Google Analytics to measure your website. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.